Welcome to the special mini-series event episode on Aquashade. Now let me explain this title here a little bit. Make them fight in the shade. Now whether you know it or not, we are in a constant battle with nuisance and toxic algae, and unfortunately in many ways we are losing and they are winning. You see, they're taking over waters across the globe and in many, many systems throughout the United States. Here's just a couple large-scale visuals for you, news articles on the plague of these cyanobacteria. Now, they've infested many waters, and they can produce all manners of toxins that can threaten wildlife and human health. They're tough. They're a plague, and the toxins are causing a health epidemic. We need every advantage and tool to combat these organisms, but the first thing we should do is make them fight in the shade, Aquashade. Why, you may ask? Well, that's what we're covering today. You see, we already talked about light being their power source and needing it to grow and get their building blocks, but there are a number of more specific reasons why Aquashade needs to be the key tool in combating these toxic algae. We're going to quickly delve into the influence of light on algae today, especially those toxic cyanobacteria, and position some technical reasons why this focus on light can give us a huge tactical advantage in management. So again, here are some key scientific-based reasons to support managing light to combat toxic cyanobacteria and other nuisance algae. First, achene germination. So these are the resting stage cells of cyanobacteria and some other nuisance algae, and they require light to germinate. Simply, they don't germinate in the dark. So if we can keep them from germinating, they simply don't show up the battle. They don't start the bloom. They don't initiate the bloom. We keep them asleep. Next, we can alter the growth rate. So even if those achenes germinate, they need light fast. They have to have a specific amount of light, certain wavelengths and spectrum of light in order to initiate that bloom and really double and form all that biomass out there. We can stop that. We can block that with Aquashade. Now third, we alter what's called the light compensation point. Basically the growing depth where they can survive and produce more energy than they burn. We change that depth with Aquashade. No longer can they grow throughout most of the water column, but only a small piece of it where they can grow. This greatly limits their ability to achieve nuisance levels quickly and the overall biomass they can achieve. Fourth, toxicity. And the toxin production rate increases with light intensity in most typical environmental scenarios. So by altering that, if you have, you know, cyanobacteria, they are less able to produce toxins and exceed threshold levels of concern for you and the wildlife out there if you have Aquashade blocking the light. Now lastly, if you have a bloom present, you can make them go to sleep, go dormant. You see, light is one of the key triggers telling them, hey, winter is coming and it's, you know, time to go into achene and drop that bloom out. Sort of like trees dropping their leaves in wintertime. We can trigger that dormancy by blocking the light with Aquashade and make them go to sleep. Just stop that bloom in their tracks. In summary, I'm not going to promise you won't have any algae when you use Aquashade, but it should make their season much shorter, less severe, and perhaps more importantly, easier for us to manage them reactively with other technologies. Aquashade is not the only weapon we have to combat these guys, but it is a critical one to weaken them, to make them wake up later, or not grow as fast, or go to sleep earlier, or just not produce as much toxin, and just overall achieve less biomass. So this is a key technology to get out in front of them and afford us these huge advantages. We need to use many tools in the fight against these toxic cyanobacteria, but remember, if you make them fight in the shade, we're in a much better position to win. Thank you for tuning in to this special mini-series event episode on Aquashade. Thank you.